suppose there must be something wrong with us to do what we did. We'd heard that there was $10,000 in that house. Once we tied up everybody and searched all over, I knew the guy that told us about it was wrong. There was no money. Dick wouldn't believe it. He went tearing around the house, banging on walls, looking for a safe. When he was done, he said he was going to go up to Nancy's room and have his way with her. I wouldn't allow it. And I told him that. So I sat with her. Dick came up and got me. We turned off the lights. We went down to the basement where Mr. Clutter and the boy was. He kept saying, no witnesses. But I thought if I waited him out, he'd give up. And we'd just leave him tied up there. And we'd drive all night, they'd never find us. We tied Mr. Clutter's wrists to a pipe over his head. And he looked hurt, so I cut him down. I even put a box out there so he could be more comfortable. He asked me about his wife and his daughter, and I said they were fine, and that they were getting ready for sleep, and it wouldn't be long till morning and they'd find them there. He was just looking at me, looking into my eyes, like he expected me to kill him, like he expected me to be the kind of person that would kill him. I was thinking, this nice man is scared of me. I was so ashamed. I mean, I thought he was a very nice man, a very gentle man. And I thought so right up until I slit his throat. I didn't know what I'd done until I heard the sound. How much money did we get? Between $40 and $50.